Hello and welcome. My name is Daria Volkova. I believe any data visualization is better when done in style. On this channel, we publish videos about Grafana to help the community learn this open source visualization tool and maximize benefits of its broad functionality. We also share the answers to common questions that no one answered yet. Today's topic is PostgreSQL in Grafana. Grafana visualizes and PostgreSQL can provide for the three most required storage needs, which are configuration storage, time series storage, and relational database storage. I will explain configuration storage, demonstrate time series storage in action, and use a relational database to store descriptive information for stock data. Let's go! What do I mean when I say storage needs? Take a look at the schema for Grafana Management Basics concept. Grafana is a visualization tool. It always has to work with other software, the data storage software that would capture business and industrial data. That concept of two players, storage and visualization, is pretty apparent. However, there is one more storage that might seem hidden at first. Some people even do not realize it exists. Right here in the rectangle representing Grafana as an application, I have Grafana user interface, which consists of configured data sources and visualization panels. Information about that configuration has to be stored somewhere. This is what the configuration storage rectangle is here for. Grafana supports three databases to store configuration information. You get the SQLite database with the default installation. SQLite is tightly coupled with Grafana UI and is good enough when you begin discovering Grafana. The other two are PostgreSQL and MySQL. These two allow decoupling to enable development and support of any real-world applications. You can then go with the default for commercial software. Provisioning is another way of storing and pushing configuration. It's optional. Provisioning is used when you create ready out-of-the-box applications. Let me know in the comment section below if the provisioning topic interests you. I plan to create a separate video about it and would appreciate your questions. Now, let's take another look at the data storage. I have TimescaleDB under PostgreSQL for a good reason. TimeScale is a genius product. Products like that emerge when clever people create simple, efficient, and useful solutions. TimescaleDB is a PostgreSQL extension that added time series database functionality to the relational database. That means you can combine regular relational data with time series and query both using SQL. Why would anyone need a time series only database after that? If you didn't know, starting from 2021, open source databases are more popular than commercial ones, according to DB Engine's ranking. In addition, time series databases are second in how fast the worldwide popularity grows. Besides that, relational databases are still the major employee databases worldwide, 72% as of January of 2023. All that makes PostgreSQL a perfect partner for Grafana. How hard is it to switch Grafana from storing configuration in a default SQLite and redirect it to PostgreSQL? Let me show you how and you decide. I open two terminals on my Mac operation system. Create a database PostgreSQL where I want to store Grafana configuration. I call it Grafana underscore configuration underscore database. Verify the database is created. I can see it listed here. Make this new database current and list all existing relations. None, precisely as it should be. Excellent, PostgreSQL is ready. Now Grafana. In my second terminal, I run the following command. Here, I download and install Volkoflab's Docker Grafana container and specify five environment variables. Database type, database host, database name, username, and password. Hit enter and wait a bit. The installation is complete. If I go back to the first terminal and list all relations, I see 114 tables Grafana created to store its configuration moving forward. And that's it. The beautiful thing here is when Grafana releases a new version, your configuration storage will be updated automatically. Where did I find all the variable names? I discovered them on the official Grafana documentation page. I will leave the link down below. You will not see the exact variable names though. The documentation sends you on a little quest to figure out the names. In the middle of the page, you can find this formula, which is GL underscore section name underscore key name. When you scroll down, you need to realize that in the square brackets, they have sections like this path or server. You scroll down to the database section, and here are those five mandatory parameters. There are more. First five are mandatory. The last step in this quest is to uppercase all key names. The docs give them in the lowercase, but all environment variables must be in upper. Now you know where I found the variables and how to run your Docker container, ensuring it points to the PostgreSQL database for configuration storage. As I mentioned earlier, PostgreSQL is superior when combining relational data with time series data. Let me show you under the hood. Here is the candlestick visualization on my Grafana dashboard. The data comes from 12data.com via API calls. These guys are so cool, they even have an API query builder. Anyways, I loaded 5-minute interval ticks for three companies: Tesla, Amazon, and United Healthcare. I loaded the data into a hypertable. Hypertable is similar to regular table, except it is optimized for data series data. TimescaleDB allows aggregation on the fly. For that, I created a materialized view that defined the time buckets via the time series specific function. I wanted 1 hour ticks. Any changes to the source table, stocks in my example, will trigger the view updates, which will not slow down the work of the source table. Right here on my dashboard, I added the filter where I could switch between 5-minute and 1 hour ticks. The logo images I store in a regular relational table in XML plus SVG format. You can find links to everything I mentioned in the description box down below. Also, check out our blog to find the codes for the dashboard from this video. Thanks for watching and see you next time!